So, greetings for the day. Welcome to another session of Computer Networks. My name is Muhammad Rahmat Ali. Let me get into the topic of tunneling. But before that, we are going to understand, like in the previous session, what we have studied. We studied about the concept of internet networking. What actually is internet networking, or the types of internet networking with reference to or with orientation to connection oriented type of networks and connection less type of networks. In a sense, we spoke about or we discussed about the virtual circuit network as well as datagram networks. In that, we have seen how data is been routed, how data is to be transferred with reference to the quality of the services, with reference to the receiving of the packets, with reference to the sequence of the packets. Now, in today's session, we are going to learn about tunneling. What actually is tunneling, the concept of tunneling, and how tunneling can be achieved. What actually is a tunneling? The definition: tunneling is a protocol that allows for the secure movement of data from one network to another. Or tunneling is a set of rules, or tunneling is a set of instruction that allows a secure movement of data or packets from one network to another network. It means when you are talking about computer network, it is always about sender, receiver, and the medium by which it is being sent. And if at all if you have a deep insight, it will talk about the protocol, routing protocols, it will talk about the quality of services, XYZ type of things. Here we are talking about a process of tunneling in which the data is being transferred from one system to another system through a secure channel. What that secure channel is about, the second point is a technique of internet networking is called tunneling is used when source and destination network of same type are to be connected through a network of different type. This is the concept of tunneling. What it says, if at all if you observe over here it is Ethernet 1 type of network, here it is Ethernet 2 type of network, but the channel which is being connected through or connected with both of the network is with reference to WAN, So it means Ethernet packet cannot be sent to WAN network because these two are different things. But the receiver is to receive the Ethernet packet. So what will be done? A tunneling or the concept of tunnel or the concept of tunneling is being used to communicate with one another. So how it has been done? It has been done with reference to the help of encapsulation. It has been done with the help of encapsulation. Like we will be grouping the data into one and we'll be sending it. It will be encrypted at the sender side and decrypted at the receiver side. We'll see what actually it is and how it has been done. For an example, let us consider an Ethernet to be connected to another Ethernet through a WAN. So in this way, a tunnel or a concept of tunneling is being used. Tunneling works by encapsulating packets. What is the concept of encapsulation? The concept of encapsulation is wrapping of the data or grouping of the data or binding of the data is called as encapsulation. That concept is called as encapsulation. Now we'll see how encapsulation is being achieved over here. What it says, wrapping packets inside of other packet is called as encapsulation or the concept of encapsulation. Now, for moving further, why is this technique called tunneling? Why is this technique called as tunneling? In this particular example, the IP packet does not have to deal with WAN. If you see over here, the IP packet does not have to deal anything with reference to this LAN. So the host A and B also do not have to deal with WAN. This host A and B does not have to deal with the WAN. Now, the multi-protocol router M1 and M2 will have to understand about IP and WAN packets. Now, this M1 and M2 have to communicate between this Ethernet and with reference to the WAN. With reference to WAN to this Ethernet. So this M1 and M2 are responsible to understand both of the things. Like in the previous session, I'll give you an example. I cannot speak English, you cannot speak Hindi. Like if at all if you are not able to communicate with one another, we should hire a person who should know English also we should know Hindi. The same thing that need to be done over here, like this M1 and M2 should know both of the packets, like understand Ethernet packet as well as WAN packet. So that is what been told over here. The multi protocol router M1 and M2 will have to understand about IP and WAN packets. Therefore, the WAN can be imaged to be equivalent to a big tunnel extending between multi protocol routers M1 and M2, and the technique is called tunneling. And the technique is called as tunneling. This is very simple. What it is, I'll give you a live example to understand what this tunneling is all about. You started from India and you want to go to, for an example, a place called as Dubai. By car you want to go from India to Dubai. So what is the route that you will be taking? You will be taking the route by road until the seashore, and later on that car will be wrapped as a parcel and will be shipped in a, like, you know, docking ship, or it will be shipped in a tanker, so that car will be transferred from India to the port of Dubai, from the port of India to the port of Dubai. In the sense, that road moving vehicle is being transferred on a water moving vehicle. In the sense, this ship is acting as a connection between road to the ship. Now this car act as one of the packets. Now, like, if you see this example, let us consider this is India and this is Dubai, and this is the part of sea or ocean that you consider. We are moving from this place and we reach the coast of India. Now the car cannot move on water. So what will be done from here? That thing will be wrapped in one of the container, and it will be shipped on the ship so that it can reach the port of Dubai, and again it will be unwrapped, and again it will take the roadway to reach Dubai. So this is what you call as tunneling. This concept is called as tunneling. So it is very simple. What is the concept of tunneling? Tunneling is a protocol that allows for secure movement of data from one network to another network, or we can say source and destination of same type of roadway to be connected through a different media of instruction, like water, or here it is WAN. This concept of whole is thing is called as tunneling. This is what to called as the concept of tunneling. Now moving further, what it says, in tunneling the data are broken into smaller pieces called as packet as they move along the tunnel for transport. In the sense, in this, every of the packet is been wrapped into a smaller version so that it can be transferred easily. And also, like, let me take another example, like this host 1 and host A and host B understand only IPv4, but the medium is of IPv6. Like this, IPv4 is to be converted into IPv6, and IPv6 is again to be converted into IPv4. So in the sense, this part should know the conversion of IPv6 to IPv4 and IPv4 to IPv6. That is what you call as tunneling. What it says over here, in tunneling the data are broken into smaller pieces called packet as they move along the tunnel for transport. In the sense, one is being broken to another, or one is being converted into another, so that is been considered a part of that particular network as local. Now what is the second point? It says, as a packet moves through the tunnel, they are encrypted and another process called encapsulation occurs. Now what do you mean by encryption or encrypted? Encryption, in the sense, normal text when added with a key is called as encrypted data. Encrypted data along with a key can be converted again into a plain data or a plain text. That is what we call as encryption and decryption. In the sense, plain text plus key is encryption, and also encryption minus key is plain text. I repeat, plain text with the key is equal to encryption. Encryption or encrypted data minus key is equal to plain text. And also it has been encapsulated. First it has been encrypted, and again it is been encapsulated or grouped together. And what the third point says, the private network data and protocol information that goes with it are encapsulated in public network transmission unit for sending. In the sense, it is been made into smaller units with reference to that local network so that the information or the packets can move easily through that particular network, considering that packet as a local network of that particular group of networks. Now, and what the next point says, the unit looks like a public data allowing them to be transmitted across the internet. Like, see, that data does not belong to that particular network, but still it is been bind, converted and grouped such that it looks like the local data. It looks like the local data for that particular network. Now, what is the last point? It says encapsulation allows the packet to arrive at their proper destination. At the final destination, decapsulation or decryption happen. Now, here encryption has happened, here decryption will happen. Encryption in small terms, I can say a normal text which is been converted to unreadable text using a key, is called as encapsulation. And the same thing that encrypted data minus the key is called as decryption. Like, for an instance, I'll give you an example. Like, you know, mostly in multiple choice type of questions, you will be using this technique, like A, B, C, and D. If at all, if you say 4 means he will say this one. It means the answer is C. It means I am encrypting a normal data using a key, a normal data A, B, C, D. With reference to a key, in the sense indicating that to an encrypted data which cannot be understood normally. Like, if at all, if I say in this way, the answer is 1, which we both know. The third person cannot know about this way because we have our own terms to understand that particular thing. So this is what we call as encryption, in the sense converting a normal data along using a key to a encrypted data or to unreadable data is called as encryption. And the same thing, if at all followed in a reverse way, is called as decryption. In the sense, when I am saying this C, like answer as C, and I am pointing towards this, you know the answer. So, like, if, as it has been decided, you know the key. So that is the reason you can understand what I am saying. This process is called as decryption. Encryption and decryption. Encryption happens at the sender side, decryption happens at the receiver side, and that data is been encapsulated and encrypted through the channel. This is the concept of tunneling. Now, coming towards the next thing, there are various protocols that allow tunneling to occur, including point-to-point tunneling protocol. So what do you mean by protocol? Protocol means a set of instructions that is been used to execute that particular thing. Now, what do you mean by this point-to-point tunneling protocol? Point-to-point tunneling protocol keeps proprietary data secure even when it is being communicated over a public network. This will help with reference to securing of the data. Like, if at all, if you remember in the first session, we spoke about the reliability of the data, in which we spoke about the security issues as well as how many times the data is been getting down and how quickly it is been recovered. That is what you call as with reference to the reliability. In the same way, when we are using the protocol, it should be secure. Now, what it says, authorized users can access a private network called virtual private network, which is provided by an internet service provider. This is a private network in virtual sense because it is actually being created in a tunneled environment. See over here. This type of network is not an actual network. It is being created. It is being made in such a way that the packets can flow through this tunnel. The packets can flow through this network. The information can be passed to this network, considering this as a local, considering my packet to be local to this network. This is what we call as tunneling. Now, what is the second thing? It says layer 2 tunneling protocol. This type of tunneling protocol involves a combination of using TP and layer 2 forwarding. We'll study about these things in the coming slides. As of now, remember this. Tunneling is a way for communication to be conducted over a private network but tunneled through a public network. This is particularly useful in corporate setting and also offers security features such as encryption options. So this is all about tunneling. I hope you got a small idea or you got a way how tunneling works, and I think you understood the concept of tunneling. Now moving forward, we will learn about the network layer in internet, or you can say IP protocol or internet protocol. The internet protocol is a principal communication protocol, an internet protocol suite for relaying datagram across network boundaries. It is routing function enables internet working and essentially establishes the network. This is a textbook type of a definition. In common, if I say IP or internet protocol is something, which helps the client to communicate with the server and to take the permission from the server to establish a connection between the client and the server, the user and the server. It means IP helps us in it helps us make a connection, to make a communication with the server, IP has a task of delivering packets from the source host to the destination host solely based on IP addresses in the packet headers. For this purpose, IP defines the packet structures and encapsulates the data to be delivered. It is also defined addressing methods that are used to label the datagram with source and destination information. Now, these all are the textbook information to remember for your examination. But to understand what actually IP is similar to like your PIN code, is similar to like your local address. If at all, if I say my PIN belongs to 500021, 5001, 50028, 5008, 5009, 5007. This indicates which area or which postal area I belong to. This PIN code addresses the area in which you live, the place you belong to, or the place where that information is to be sent, where that particular letter is to be delivered, where that particular parcel is to be delivered, is been indicated by the PIN code. In the same way, internet protocol also tells you where the network belongs to, where the packet is to be sent, and from where the packet has come. This all of the information is being stored in internet protocol, and also it helps us in routing the packets from correct source to correct destination, from correct destination to the required source. This is all about internet protocol. Now what it says, IP address, IP addresses are being classified in two types based on their address type. The first one is IPv4 and the second one is IPv6. IPv6 has been used in modern type of communication, whereas previously IPv4 or IP version 4 was to be used for communication which has 32 bit of address, each containing 8 bit of address, wherein these first two addresses tells about the host network, whereas the last two 8 bits of network tells about the home network, where it should be delivered, from where it belongs to. The first two 8 bits of address tells from where it has come and where it belongs to. The second type of 8 bit addresses tells about where actually it is to be received and where it is, where actually it is to be received and when it is to be received. That has been defined in this particular IP address. If at all, if you see 172.16.254.1, this actually is an IP address. And also, when you take an internet, you will be given a unique ID with reference to using your internet, that you call it as IP address. If at all, if you make a complaint with reference to internet, the internet service provider will ask you what is your IP address so that it can be resolved. So that is what you call as IP address. and that IP address has got 32 bit of data, in which each 32 bit of data consisting of 4 8 bits of data, in which the first 2 8 bits of data indicates the host address, or what you call as the network address, whereas the next 2 8 bit of data tells you about the destination address or the home address. Or the home address. This is what you called as IP addressing. So what it says, the major version of IP, Internet Protocol version 4, is dominant protocol of the internet. It is a successor. Its successor is Internet Protocol version 6, which has been in increasing deployment on public interest since 2016. Now what is this all about? Now to tell you a small story about this IP address and all these things. To tell you a small thing, like internet or IP was never been designed for public use. This IP address was never been designed for public use. This was been designed to use for military communication purpose. This was been used to communicate in military transactions, wherein one source and destination was far away, but through this type of network or through this IP address they used to communicate. But later on it was been given access to the people, for normal people, for access, so that they also can be used. But basically it was been defined for military purpose. This was defined for the defense purpose. And also I'll tell you one important interesting fact, like if at all if you observe, IP addresses has got some classes. IP addresses have got some classes, A, B, C type of classes, wherein class A is being used by military purpose. The class A address is used for only for the purpose of military, wherein class B addresses are being used for government use, or you can say for the governmental purpose, whereas class C, D and E and F are used for the public purpose. If at all you never heard any IP address which says like 128.162.130.1. You will never hear any of the IP address. You will always hear IP address saying 192.193.194.195. But because this class of address is being designed for the public use. I repeat it once again. The IP addresses are being classified based on their network addresses into many of the classes. Class A, Class B, Class C, Class D, Class E, wherein Class A type of address is only particular for defense purpose, for military purpose, wherein the Class B type of addresses is being used for governmental purpose or only for the government recognized institutions. The IP address that you will be getting for government organizations will be ranging from 128 to 191. And if at all if your the IP address that is to be given to the public starts from 192, the IP addresses for general public starts from 192 and ends with reference to 223 and so on and so forth. But as of now, this is the story of IP addressing or IP or Internet Protocol version 4 in the current generation, or in the present day. IP version 6 type of protocol is being implemented for many of the things, and in future we are going to use the IP version 6 type of internet protocol. So that's all for today. I hope you understand something about the process of tunneling and with reference to internet protocol. If at all if you have any doubt with reference to the today's session, please let me know. Please ping me on my email address rahmat_ali2u@yahoo.com. That's all for today. Have a nice time. Have a great day. Thank you. See you in the next session.